New at 6, a follow-up to a story we brought you a month ago. It's a new type of cochlear implant, and it got its first test drive today in San Antonio as part of a post-FDA approval trial. Now, this is a hybrid type of cochlear, one that many hearing impaired have been waiting for.
Jennifer Shearer's son is doing something she remembers from childhood but had forgotten.
Because it screeches until I get used to it.
A simple, high-pitched whistle. Today, it's enough to send her into tears. She lost that part of her hearing long ago, but it wasn't until now that she could get it back. Jennifer fell into a category that did not qualify her for a regular cochlear implant, but rather one that helps her get high-frequency sounds only.
So they're getting some benefit from a hearing aid, but they're not getting the information in the high frequency range, like the consonant sounds, S's, T's, F's, and they still have troubles distinguishing words.
We were there as she got the original surgery, similar to regular cochlear surgery, but this hybrid device lets Jennifer retain her natural low frequency hearing ability and only adds the high range.
The doctors had to wait 30 days after surgically placing the implant in her ear before they could turn it on. They wanted to make sure that the body had recovered from any trauma it suffered. Then, that magic moment.
Do it again. Can you hear that? That's a good thing.
Now, she's going to continue to have to get used to that high-pitched sound, which to her untrained ear right now sounds downright screechy, and this could take a few months. The Ear Institute of Texas is not the first in Texas to install these new hybrids, but Dr. Jackson is the only doctor in the study in the state.